Parable of the Sower by Octavia E. Butler. Recently, for my sci-fi video I put out yesterday, I came across this author and was really interested in checking out her work just because of how highly her praises were sung by so many. But on top of that, due to current events, I'm also more interested in checking out some Black authors right now and expand my horizons in that direction. And this was an amazing place to start. And for anyone who's in a similar mindset right now, Parable of the Sower, wow. Wow. Now, with my critique hat on, there are some minor things we're going to get into here and there, but in general, this is going to be an overwhelmingly positive review. But let's go ahead and get into the setting and plot. This takes place in a dystopian America. Flat out America, like they're in California. Global warming, along with corporate greed, racial divides, and just the darker sides of humanity have led to a downfall of society, and now while there are few gated communities left, in general, most people are suffering and starving. The way this world is written, and so many of the things that Octavia Butler hit on in the year 2026 where this takes place, are bothersome how accurate they seem to be. It's disturbing. But there's an underlying feeling of hope, and that comes from our main character this story follows, Lauren Alemagne. She is a preacher's daughter who begins to question the Baptist teachings that her father preaches. And the beginning of this book is really just hanging out with her when she's 15 to 18, understanding her life and the world she currently lives in. And this philosophy and what eventually turns into a religion she is developing called Earth Seed. Quick cut in here I want to add, because I think what I just said could be interpreted as this book as being anti-religious, like the whole setup of the preacher's daughter no longer believing what her Baptist father preaches. It's not necessarily. I would say Earthseed instead is just a very detailed critique of humans' relationship with religion without necessarily targeting the religions themselves. It's fascinating, but I just want to say it's not, in my opinion, at least my interpretation, what I read, anything that is vehemently anti-current established religions, more just a character who is pulling away from them and facing the realities they are living in and developing their own ideology from there. But as safety bubbles are in dystopians, her gated community is destroyed, and she must now venture towards safety in the north, parallels obvious there, to try and find some form of refuge, gathering followers along the way, where her kind of philosophy begins appealing to more and more people. Like, the title alone for this book, Parable of the Sower, is an obvious biblical reference, where you have someone sowing seeds, and while most of them are destroyed and actually yield no growth, some do, and there's beauty in that. And that's kind of the ray of hope for this story here. While you're seeing so many tragic, awful things occur, there's just this, oh, but there's rays of goodness, there's spots of the good of humanity left. And while you're following this character who is such a central beacon of that light, it ends up kind of leaving you with this feeling of optimism despite the circumstances the world is in. I haven't even mentioned the kind of borderline magical thing that exists here, and that is that our main protagonist, Lauren, also has this ability called hyper-empathy, where she physically feels the pain and suffering of others. And there's one point where in this book where it's kind of asked, like, wouldn't it be great if every human had this, where they felt physically what they did to others in this way? And my immediate response was, oh my god, yes. I just want to hit on one last time how believable. This might be the most believable dystopian vision of the future I've ever seen, to the point where, like, the only night where I was, like, actually sitting on it after I read this book and I was gonna pick it up again the next morning because I finished it in 2 days, I was laying in bed being like, Octavia Butler might have been a prophet, just like her character. Oh my god. And now I want to talk about Octavia Butler's voice, because she has this incredible ability to write Parable of the Sower with this kind of disconnect. Well, there is this emotional dryness to the actual words she puts to the page, but the actions of her characters, and especially this view of hyper-empathy we have with main character Lauren, makes it so there's still these really heavy emotional moments that hit you hard. And I think they hit all the harder because we have this almost detached narrative first person voice. It's an interesting combination I've definitely not seen before, where you have first person perspective, but it's kind of disconnected because we're reading this, like, recounting narrative, but it just, it worked so well. Also sprinkled throughout the text, we get these passages from this new religion our character is starting, Earth Seed, and the Book of the Living, which she is crafting. And each one of these just hits like a poem that really vibes with not only this world that's established, but probably an exaggerated sense of many of the things you felt in this world, or maybe not that exaggerated. But let's get into this religion real quick, because I want to actually touch on that, because Earth Seed isn't necessarily, you notice how I hesitated to call it a religion at the beginning of the video, because it is actually like, we're not about any godlike figures. Instead, God is change, God is chaos, and it's about how humans look out for each other and themselves in this more darker world. And really the destiny this religion foresees is that humanity is supposed to reach into the stars, leaving Earth behind. Apparently what Octavia Butler's goal here was to do was write a character who felt very human, but was someone who definitely could come across as soon as they died, being viewed as a religious figure or even prophetic and godlike. Absolutely accomplished that. Holy crap. I think the only large criticism I have towards this is some of the pacing. It just kind of seems like this book falls into the things happened formula, and while it's never formulaic, it doesn't feel like things are repeating themselves. And this does kind of fit the narrative because we're being recounted events that are important in this journey. It is just every single page, okay, what's happening next, 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 which isn't necessarily bad pacing, but it doesn't have that structure of up and down. It's more of just a straight line across. So I've talked about Octavia Butler's narrative voice and how effective it is at communicating the story. Her prose as well, I just want to compliment as a separate entity as a whole. She is definitely more of a poetic writer, where you are going to be reading passages and then rereading them because they're just so well put together and the word choice is so perfect that things are going to continually hit you in the gut. Is just like, that's next level right there. And you can't talk about this book without talking about the themes, right? I mean, just from the premise alone, I said at the beginning, where we have global warming, racial injustice, economic divide, corporate greed, resulting in dystopian America, inevitably you are going to have themes that reflect our own world. And this, God, just felt so possible. And the fact that she wrote this back in 1993, and there are certain things where it's like, yep, she called it. Like, that's like, oh no, that's happening. But even the more subtextual themes that I think aren't as direct reflections of our own world, but are certainly important, I want to mention, like knowledge and power. Our main character, Lauren, who, by the way, is a fantastic character and very well realized, early on in the book is preaching to her friend how knowledge is power. And there's this very believable conversation. I've actually had similar ones with friends where it's like, yeah, I get what you're saying, knowledge is power, whatever. And they kind of shrug it off. They don't really realize how true that sentiment is. Reading is so important, and there's specifically a conversation in this book that happened where I was like, yes, preach, my God, I've been saying this forever, read more, it'll make you a better person, it'll make you a smarter person, it'll equip you to survive in the world. And that, there's just countless ones of those in this where you can't read it as like a knowledgeable reader and not take away like, that is something that has been in my life. It's a conversation I've had, and I support the message that's being put here. At least I hope you would. It's 100%. And I'm going to be thinking about for a while how Octavia Butler wrote a story where it was a little bit drawn back in the emotional writing sense, where she's not super passionate, yet there was still so many emotions I felt as someone reading this for the first time. I still can't figure out how she exactly did that. There's absolutely no glorification of violence, but there is a lot of brutality in this book. So if you are someone who doesn't enjoy that in their writing, fair warning, you will see some gross, darker things. You know, this is one of those dystopians where you see the darkest sides of that dystopian. That's actually kind of a pet peeve of mine in sci-fi dystopians, where they have like, oh, the world's so dark, and you don't see it much. You see it here. The ending also, I guess I'm in a streak of this now, is a bit chopped off. I wanted maybe a little bit more narratively, but I'm aware there's a second book. I definitely plan on reading that because this one is probably my favorite sci-fi book I've read this year. Ooh, I read Three Body Problem this year. I don't know, I'll have to think about that. But unfortunately, Octavia Butler did pass before she was able to finish this series. So if that is an immediate deal breaker for you because you need that catharsis, you need the reaching the end of the stories you read, I don't blame you. But aside from that, I absolutely recommend this, especially right now when so many people are looking for books that can help them better understand a lot of the what's going on in America. If you want to do that through a sci-fi fantasy lens, this is a damn good way to do it, because there's a lot to take away from here. Overall, I'm giving Parable of the Sower a strong 8.5 to 9 out of 10. There was a slight pacing thing, and the ending I wasn't entirely satisfied by. But aside from that, this is damn near flawless, and it's one of those stories where you just like feel it and you're like, oh, this is exactly what it needs to be, and I can't change a word. But for fans of Octavia Butler that are out there, let me know in the comments down below, which books of hers should I check out next? I'm aware she has quite the bibliography behind her, so I'm eager to explore that. And again, a lot of the videos you'll be getting this weekend are pre-recorded due to me moving. I recorded them a few days ago and they'll be put out, so just enjoy those. They're more fun, lighthearted stuff. So you'll be getting one fantasy news and then some pre-recorded videos, and then maybe I'll miss a day or two because moving. Like and subscribe if you have not already. Hit the Patreon if you want to support what I do here. And have a good one, y'all. Peace.